Hi everybody, welcome to Shell Lectures. So today we'll be dealing with precision and accuracy. Precision and accuracy. So what is the difference between these two terms? What is the difference in meaning between these two terms? For example, let us take the measurements taken by three students to get a clear idea. Student A, B, C. Student A's first measurement is 1.95 and the second measurement is 1.93, and the true value or the average value is 1.940. Here it's 1.94, 2.05, 1.995, 2.01, 1.99, 2.000. So these are the three measurements which are taken by people along with the average value. So for the experiment which student A conducted, the average value is 1.940, or the true value or the mean value, that is the correct value. Okay, so the first time student A got 1.95 and the second time 1.93. Student B got 1.94 and 2.05. Student C got 2.01 and 1.99 for these two true values respectively. So now we can come to know the meanings of the words precision and accuracy from this itself. So first let me write the short definition for precision, that is closeness of individual values. Accuracy, closeness of individual value to the true value. So this is precision and this is accuracy. So from the definition itself we can come to know. Precision is closeness of individual values. So these are all the individual values which are taken and this is the true value. Okay. So how much the individual values which are taken by the students are closer, that's what is known as precision. And accuracy is nothing but the closeness of the measured values to the true value. That is the closeness of the individual values to the true value. For example, if we take student A for instance, his values are 1.95 and 1.93. Are they both very close to each other? Of course. Am I right? 1.95 is not very far away from 1.93. So both of them are going to be very close to each other. So this student A's measurement is very precise. It's very precise because they are both very close. But closeness of the individual value to the true value, let's take that. 1.95, 1.93, 1.94. Not very bad. It's okay, we can say, but not as, it's not as accurate as it's precise. Okay, it's more precise. It's more precise, but its accuracy is not up to the level. Okay, it's okay, that's it. It's not very close to the true value, but of course we can write it's accurate. It's just accurate, but highly precise. Now coming on to B, 1.84 and 2.05. These are the two individual values. Are they close to each other? No. So not precise. At the same time, they are not also related to the true value. Okay, these two values are not close to the true value rather. So we can say it's neither precise nor accurate. The measurement taken by student B is neither precise nor accurate. Now coming on to C, this is 2.01 and 1.99, very, 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 very close to each other. Am I right? So these two are precise because the values are very close. Also, this value is very close to the true value. 2.01, 2.00, 1.99, 2.00. So the true values or the true value flow match is also very well established. So the measurement taken by student C is both accurate and precise. So here, as the values are closer to each other, the measurement is more precise but not more accurate. Here neither precise nor accurate because the values are not closer to each other plus it's not also closer to the true value. Here the values are also closer to each other plus it's also closer to the true value. So it's both precise and accurate. So this is what is about precision and accuracy. Now, rounding off. So if I have to round a number, for example, let me take a number as 1.386. Okay, this is the first number which we'll discuss, and it's the second number. So with these four numbers, we can finish off this topic, rounding off. So how can we round off? Rounding off is nothing but rounding a particular number to a very estimated value. So here the uncertain digit must be seen. Okay, so the uncertain digit is what will decide the previous number. So if the uncertain digit is greater than 5, first we learn the rules. The uncertain digit is nothing but A point B C D. Then D is the uncertain digit here. Okay, D is the uncertain digit here. So if the uncertain digit is greater than 5, then to C you must add 1. So C plus 1. If the uncertain digit is lesser than 5, then C remains as it is. C remains as it is. Okay. And if the uncertain digit is equal to 5 and C is an even number, you need not change it. C remains as it is. And if the uncertain digit is equal to 5 and C is an odd number, then you have to add 1 to C. Okay, so this is the basic rule. We'll do this now. So the uncertain digit here is 6, which is greater than 5. So I have to add plus 1 to the previous number. So what is the answer? 1.39. Here also the number is greater than 5. So let me say that 4. So it becomes lesser than 5. Alright, so the uncertain digit here is lesser than 5. So I have to leave the previous digit as it is. Okay, so the answer would be 1.34 after I remove this number, the last number. Here the last number is itself 5, so I have to check the previous number. If it's even, then I can leave it as it is and write it as 1.38. And if the previous number is odd, I have to add one more number and make it as 1.38. Okay, so if the last digit is greater than 5, the preceding digit, we have to add 1. Or if it's less than 5, the preceding digit stays as it is. Or if the uncertain digit is 5, then if the previous number is even, you can leave it as it is. If it's odd, you have to add one more digit. So that's it for today. Subscribe to my channel if you have not done so far. Like and share this video to whomever you know. Thank you.